Oh, shit. Complete my pre-order. Yes. Well, wow. Buy album. Yes, I will. Mr. Mathers. Yes, I will. Let's go. Here it is. All right. Give me some time to digest. Here we go.
That's right. All right. It's here. The new Eminem. I got it. I waited. I knew that it downloaded. It leaked online yesterday. I waited till midnight to get it because I don't believe in stealing music. Especially if it's an artist that I love, and I love Eminem so much. I waited. It killed me. I did cheat a little bit by reading the lyrics online. That's it. This is my reaction, my review. I probably might do like a lengthier review later, like another one, once I digest the album more. I've listened to it once. All right, let's go. Right to it. Right to it. Right to the review. And the reaction. Can you tell by my reaction how excited I am? It's good. All right, can you see it? Right there. Yeah, okay, right there. That's Revival. Look, come on. There it is, yep. I really didn't think this day would come. Okay, now, Chloroseptic. Let's hear a little snippet. All right, so I'm not gonna do Walk on Water. That's the first track. I'm gonna go right into the second track, which is Chloroseptic, featuring Fresher. If you watch my other video about Eminem, he's a Brooklyn rapper. Okay, so when I first put on Chloroseptic, I was a little kind of like, okay, what's this? What's going on here? Wasn't too sure. Then it gets going. And I really like it. It's a little bit of a different style for Eminem. The first three, four songs are not typical Eminem songs at all. At all. At least I don't think so. And I'm a pretty big fan. I don't think they're very typical of Eminem. Different style. Okay, let's do a little snippet of Chloroseptic. After Walk on Water, the first track actually is something called Believe. And it's different. I said Chloroseptic. I was wrong. It's Believe, then Chloroseptic. I'm just learning the album, people. So it's Believe, then Chloroseptic. Let's hear a little bit of Believe right now. It's got a cool hook. M, it's all M. No guests on it. I haven't been able to pick out the sample yet, if there's a sample in it. I'm pretty good at finding samples, figuring them out right away. Student of hip-hop, student of music. Love it. All right, here's a little bit of Believe. I blew up on quick, that's why they called me Firecracker. I grew up on wick, but a short fuse. I got some important news to report to. Anyone who thought I was done, nah, bitch, not white spot. Lights back on top, my fate, where's yours? Do you still believe in me? Didn't I get everything I had to give you to me? So that's a little bit of Believe, slower track. I thought it'd be a more blistering second track after Walk on Water. I thought it was gonna kick in a lot harder, but it's cool. It's setting up the groove of the album, how it goes. It's got a great flow. This is an album, people. This is not just a collection of songs. This is an album. I listened to it right from the beginning and it flows so perfectly. It ebbs, it flows, it's got valleys, it's got, I was gonna say lows, but there ain't no lows on an Eminem album. All right, next track, Chloroseptic. Why am I squinting in the middle of the night? It doesn't make any sense. I'm sorry. So this is the second track, third track with Fresher, Brooklyn MC. And here it comes. In a second. I really like Fresher. I'm at your throat, I'm feeling reckless. And that's like 100 of you. 100 of you. All at once. See, this part, this sounds like new rap to me, which is great. It's great. But definitely a new style of rap for Eminem. Kind of sounds like it's got that mumble rap beat, but Eminem can't mumble. It's not in his DNA. Anyways, it's a good song. All right, on to the next. Next track is Untouchable. We've all heard it already. It's got the Cheech and Chong sample. I'm gonna skip right over this. Not that I don't like it. I love it. Love it. Especially this part. I keep telling myself, keep doing like you're doing. No matter how many lives you ruin, it's for the red, white, and blue. Time to go find a new one. Sung from two different points of view, maybe even a third. I think it's Eminem's point of view in the middle part, but definitely from a cop's point of view and African America's point of view. But I feel like there's a little bit of an Eminem point of view put into the middle. Anyways, great song. Next song. Oh boy, this is a hit single. But I gotta hear Untouchable. Yeah, I put on the hat. Okay, next song. Alright. This one's River. This is the one featuring Ed Sheeran. I was skeptical. It's amazing. It's about a dude sleeping with a married woman. Then he ends up leaving her. It's an abortion happens. It's a good song. That's the hook. Sung by Ed Sheeran. Oh yeah. Yeah. Alright, okay, I can't play too much, but because there's a lot of songs. Alright, on to the next. Yeah, I hope it doesn't seem like I'm giving like short shrift to these songs. Like I'm just playing bits of them and talking about them. But I'm going. That's my phone ringing. I didn't. I'm picking up. Give me a minute. Yes, that's the office theme. Hold on, please. Yeah, what up? No, I'm doing a YouTube video. Yeah, in my car. I'm reviewing an album. Your album. Yeah. Yes. I told you I was going to do it. Sorry, I have to take this. Yo, Em, you got to call me back, man. I got to finish this review. Okay. All right. No. I'll call you in the morning. It's late. Okay. I'm so sorry. Okay, no, you hang up. All right. Aw, he's so needy. Okay, and now the next track is an intro to the next song, which is called Remind Me. And so far, it's kind of my favorite track on the album. It's the poppiest, that's for sure. It's definitely a return to Slim Shady styles. It's kind of like a Berserk-style song. Samples Joan Jett and the Blackhearts. I bet you a lot of music reviewers are going to call him on that and say, oh, that song has been sampled so many times, blah, blah, blah. You know how many kids probably don't know that song? How new it's going to be to so many people? Old record reviewers, go review something else, okay? All right, let's see a little bit of it. Here it goes. Yeah. I bust in, never lush green, disgusting, asshole, freckled cheeks and a butt chin. Calling our party animals, get on the floor, but so all I'm gonna play of that. Get the album. That, yeah, this, love this song. Love this song instantly. All right, let's go to the next track. Let's go. Next track is a little bit of an interlude. Gonna take it down low. Then it goes into another song I think is made. This song is the most anti-Trump, most anti-Republican. This song is the one featuring Alicia Keys, Like Home. I got a lump in my throat. I got chills when I heard it. I swear I did. As soon as I heard it. It's really good. It's really good. Okay. Let's play a little bit. Here we go. Someone get this Aryan a sheet. Time to bury him, so tell him to prepare to get impeached. Everybody on your feet. This is where terrorism and hair was. Definitely the most political song on the album. This chump barely even sleeps. All he does is watch Fox News like a parrot and repeats. While he looks like a canary with a beak. Why you think he banned transgenders from the military with a tweet? He mentions Heather from Charlottesville. Get the scars to heal and band together for Charlottesville and for Heather. Fallen heroes, fill his wall with murals. No pad, I get up, hit the damn resetter. Let's start from zero. This is our renewal. Straight tank, get rid of. Get a brand new better America. And it's Alicia Keys. Alright, that's all I'm going to play of that. I've avoided, today, reading any reviews online about it until I did my own review. But I can't escape searching Eminem on my Twitter feed and my Instagram. And just, well, I just can't help it. But I tried not to read full stuff, but then it seems like there's getting a little bit of mixed reviews. It's just haters. They don't know what they're talking about. So far, this utterly biased review is completely in favor of the new Eminem. It's amazing. All right, on to the next track. All right, this is the one featuring X-Ambassadors, one of my favorite bands, and one of my favorite albums from 2015. Gotta swipe this stupid notification away. Yeah. First, I wasn't too into the song. I listened to it a second time. I love it. It's all about, I did read the lyrics online, so I know, I got kind of, wrapped up in reading the lyrics. I read the lyrics to every track. This one is from the heart. This is about Kim. Now, you know, he does rap about Kim. He does rap about Haley. He does rap about his other two daughters. He does rap about his mom. He raps about his father. Not just on this track. I'm talking about many tracks throughout it. You know what? At least he's not rapping about drugs. Well, he does rap about drugs, obviously. But, you know, selling drugs. He's not rapping about money, throwing bills. Well, he does a little bit. But M raps from the heart. M raps about what he knows. M raps about his life. He's the most personal rapper that you're ever probably going to listen to, or I'm ever going to listen to. And it's not junk rap. I like it. It's junk rap. It's not, you know, what am I talking about? Just listen to the album. Okay. It's so good. All right, this song. This sounds kind of like Love the Way You Lie Part 2. It's written by Skylar Grey. This song, probably the hook's written by Skylar Grey. She wrote this with Eminem. It definitely sounds like the same couple from Love the Way You Lie a few years later. That's what I gathered from it on first listen after reading the lyrics. But definitely just on listening. It's got the same vibe. It's not as hard as Love the Way You Lie. It's a little softer. It's a great song. But of course, I'm utterly biased. Here we go.
I was never nothing special. I don't need to be reminded of it every other second, especially when
if you're an Eminem fan, you're gonna love this album. If you're not an Eminem fan, you're gonna love a lot of the songs. Maybe some of them aren't gonna be for you. If you're an Eminem hater, go watch something else. Or I'll give your honest opinion. I respect it. Just don't be rude about it or mean about it. This is an utterly biased review. This is a review for fans. Because I'm shameless. I love Eminem. And I was kind of like, oh, these first three, four songs, I'm not too sure about how they flow together. And then it really kicks in. Then the album as a whole just kind of came at me in a huge wave. Big wave. So good. All right, on to the next track. For those who want the old Slim Shady, this next track, Framed, is definitely the old Slim Shady. It's all about murdering people. He's got his serial killer fantasies, and this song is all about it, and it's so good, and it's called Framed. Let's hear a little bit of Framed. Well, there we go. He's playing the character, people. He's not really a serial killer. All right. Next song. Yeah. That song's called Frame. So I know I am just going through these songs really quickly. I might do a full like review, like really break down each song. But this is just to get this up quickly online. My reaction review. My first reaction to the album. Oh, it was hard not to want to download last night when I heard that it leaked, but couldn't do it, and I won't do it, and I don't think you should do it. It's on iTunes. Buy it now. It's a good price. 19 tracks. 2 interludes. You know, come on. Just 17 Eminem songs for not a lot of money. All right, next song. Let's see what it is. I should know. I feel like I should know it by now. I should know right off my heart the track listing, but okay, look. Not too much going on up there. Not just that rack, though. This is a track featuring Kalani. This is another political track from what I gathered from the lyrics. I kind of think it references the Manchester bombings. It talks about him playing Wembley Stadium, but it does say it's a lot about terrorism. And about how the world's going in a spiral down into the toilet. But after the vote in Alabama, it looks like things are shooting up. Let's hope. I'm Canadian, though. So, I just, you know, but I love America. I do love it so much. So I want you guys back on your feet completely. Well, you already kind of are, but I want you really back on your feet. I'm not getting political, because I'm a very political person. I actually am very, very, I'm really political, but I'm leaving it out of this. Plus, I want to be loud in the United States. I don't want my political views out there. I love everyone. I really do. I love everyone. Okay, so this is Nowhere Fast featuring Kalani. Here we go.
But you forced me in the corner. I'm sure to have something for your ear. And in the course of the assault, as torture gets more severe. Go to war with me, you end up blue to ten. I run, I just move on clocks. Forever young, make time stop. Will I ever fall off? That day will never come to the pine box. Bitch, fuck you. I'm better than I ever was.
Oh, he just swore. Eminem swore. I'm not gonna swear. Eminem swore on an album. It's already fucked and I'm on top. So I don't know if I agree with that. Beautiful song, love it. All right, on to the next one. Here we go.
I actually have to get out of my car and just think for a second, because the wordplay is coming too fast, too hard, too strong. I need to bury myself in that snow. That's what I have to do. Like Justin Ross, Harris, Heather Heyer. It's crazy. Oh, man. Oh, man. I'm going in the snow.
Okay, this next song is one of my favorites on the album. As soon as I heard the first sample, the first like guy talking in the beginning, I knew exactly what it was. I didn't know what the chorus was going to be. I knew that was Mark Wahlberg's voice, and I knew what movie it was from. One of my favorite movies, Boogie Nights. Let's see if you can hear it.
You'll take it from the top.
Lady, you remind me of my raps on that relapse shit. Cause you got an ass thick as them accents.
Great song. Okay, but I'm going to play the chorus, because the chorus is the best, because it's from one of the funniest parts of Boogie Nights. Boogie Nights. Great song. I don't know what this sample is, though. This part here. It's in my head, but I don't know. Oh, it's going to be in my head. That's coming up. All right. Here we go. So on this track, called Heat, featuring Mark Wahlberg. Doesn't say featuring Mark Wahlberg, but it is. He mentioned Donald Trump a few times, too. He really comes down hard on Trump on this album. Here we go. Here comes Boogie Night sample. Hilarious. I had the Boogie Night soundtrack from years ago. And I love that part of the movie. I love that song in the movie. So the fact that M sampled it. Okay, on to the next track. Oh yeah, here it is. I'm sure someone will, or I will. It'll come online soon. This song's called Offended. It's a long jam. It's just am rapping, which is all you need. That's all you need. All right, here we go. This one. This is Pink. It's called Need Me. She sings at the beginning. Then M comes on and sings with her. M is singing. And then he raps. Then she sings again. That's it. This song's not very long. And it's only one verse, really, I think, if I recall correctly. I might be getting a few of these things wrong. Remember, I just listened to it once. But it's a great song. Love it. Okay, here he comes. Em's gonna sing with her right around now. I think. I'm gonna remember. Here's M singing now. What could I do without that? Maybe that's why I come back. He sings occasionally, but this song, really kind of, his voice is kind of more out there. Okay, this is another song from the album. This is called In Your Head. As soon as I heard the first second of it, Children of the 90s unite. It's the Cranberries on an Eminem album. Listen. Here he goes, now he's gonna rap over the whole song. Got that Cranberries guitar in the background. Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. But of course, this is utterly biased. So this is the second last song of the album. It's called Castle. I've been reading online. I gotta swipe that away. I've been reading online that the last few songs are kind of together. Kind of got that vibe. It's about his daughters. The last... Oh, here we go. Okay, well, listen to a little bit of this. Let me skip through it. Here we go.
No, got a prediction for the future. I'm hoping that you open this envelope when you're older and it holds true.
So it's a good track. It flows right into the last song on the album, which already I read about a little bit online. People thinking that he's saying it's his last album. No, people, you got to listen to the lyrics. It's exactly the opposite. He's not saying it's his last album. He's rapping about almost from 10 years ago when he has a bad drug addiction. And he's talking about, okay, here we go. Well, I'll go to the last song. So this song's called Castle, which goes into the next song called A Rose, which samples Bette Midler, The Rose. Everybody's favorite tear-jerking song. Tear-jerking? That sounds weird. Tear-jerker. Okay. Only I would sample Bette Midler, The Rose. I love it because Justin Bieber dissed Bette Midler. Now M samples Bette Midler. I think he knew what he was doing with that. So this song is about M on his deathbed, it sounds like. When he overdosed. And this would have been his last words to his daughters. He's got Haley and the two other girls he takes that he's taking parentage of. Kim's daughter with another gentleman. And also Kim's sister who passed away, I think, last year. Her daughter as well. Or was it sometime soon? Sam's a great guy. So this song, he mentioned his last album. Okay, listen. I've been a music fan for a long time now. No band ever really announces this is our last album. It's very rare. And M would not do that. Like, no. It's not his last album, people. He's got more coming. He sounds reinvigorated on this album. He sounds better than ever. He sounds angry. He sounds happy. And this track, the last two tracks, are definitely a throwback to when he had his overdose. That's what I'm gathering from it. And then at the end, he raps. Well, I'm going to let you listen to what he says at the very end. Okay? Oh yeah, and this is an utterly biased review, which means... See? A new day is dawning. It means he's back. Eminem is back. And stop. That's it for that review. I love it. This was an utterly biased review. And for all the haters out there, sorry, but I'm still on top. Still the best rapper of all time. Number one, the GOAT. And this album is amazing. It's utterly biased. I have no problem admitting that. I went into it wanting to love it. I kind of liked it at first, then started to really love it. Now I love it. It's an amazing album. Buy it. Listen to it. Love it. And it's not his last album. He's got a lot more coming. All right. Oh. And if you like this, subscribe. Because I'm going to do more reviews. In years to come. In days to come. In months to come. And hopefully Eminem will release an album once a year from now on. Because that would make my life... very happy. All right. Peace. So did I mention... Cassie. Subscribe. Subscribe. Oh, yeah. And in case you're thinking, this dude looks tired, man. What's wrong with this guy? Look at those circles. That's because I was up all day working on something else. Then I had to fly across the city to go see Last Jedi. My review for that is up. Should be up right now. Go watch that. My review and reaction to seeing Last Jedi on opening night. And then I had to get this album. And then I had to edit it quickly, put it together, put it up online. Now, subscribe. And that's it for me. All right. Peace again. Peace.